So first, what we're doing is we have cleaned up that second thinning. We are now working on, this is the woodpecker first thin. Gotta get these bushes right here. And we're getting ready to set up our second loader. Yeah, man. Anyway, we're getting ready to set up the old loader. Me and Mickey fixing to make some wood. Me and Steven been cutting pretty well 2 days here now. Steven been cutting 2 days. I cut about maybe a day now with him. And it's going right there. Anyway, Steven's way ahead, so we fixing to make some hay on over here. I ain't worried about that stump. Over here. Come over here. Mickey gonna pull it up. That's a strong loader. He keeps trying to get me too close to that loader over. I don't want him that close. He's making a pass over on the whole side he don't need to be. But anyway, we're getting ready to set both loaders up. We're going to delim wood really hard the rest of the day and try and get this going. Y'all just sit tight. We're going to watch them get this. Probably watch Michael drag that other loader in here. We'll need to get these bushes right here. Let me go point this stump out there. Did he see it? Yep, he saw it. So this would be like cleanup number 5, I think, in a row. But at least this one, there's like a couple of weeks here, maybe. Should be a couple of weeks here. But it should be a couple weeks here, and we'll, this won't be like where we've been at, where you work a day, hop around, work a day, hop around. That stuff eats you up. Oh, almost. Got one more. Anyway, we gotta, hopefully this one, with us being able to work both shears, both loaders, all this other mess, we'll be able to do what we need to get done. So. Where Mickey's going? Might be going down there, let them legs down on that loader. I keep forgetting the legs messed up on that thing. Michael can't drag it around with the legs up. So. Or down. Legs would be down. But anyway. So now we're ready to stick the loader in here. Y'all stick around. So we decided to leave this clip in here. What this is we had to push a tree in the corner of the set for Michael to make his turn. And because Steven wasn't nowhere around at the time that needed to cut. So we just pushed it. Kelly was trimming the truck that y'all see in the background. So, I mean, he's like right there. So I just said, hey, walk over here and cut this off for me. And little did I know, Kelly struggled with his saw and keeping it sharp and everything, and y'all can see this right here. And it started off
I anyway, yeah, we're just, y'all can see what's going. I guess we should title this video, you know, how not to sharpen your pole saw. Because, I mean, it's smoking. It's literally smoking because it is cutting so dull. So, anyway, that's what's going on here. All right, so what we're doing here is, you know, obviously de-limbing wood, but we're not fully de-limbing the wood. You can see I dig the majority of the bushes, the trash, out of the wood, and then I pull it up and I cut the tops off, and then I lay it over for Mickey to run through the delimiter. And this stuff, with our operation the way it is now, I know I said before two loaders working together, and this is still technically two loaders working together, but I've always, my loader would have the box, because the loader that's set out in the set doing what I'm doing normally has the box, but that loader doesn't stay running all day long, so therefore, it does not add up to put the delimiter out there. So we leave the delimiter with Mickey's loader by the road. This actually helps out quite significantly. You go from, I mean, pushing really hard to do, which I'm only running this machine 4 hours a day at max. And you go from struggling to do 10 loads a day in this type of timber to you easily do 12. So that's what we're doing here. It's a form of delimbing. The biggest thing is we're doing what I call cleaning the wood up. You know, you get the bushes out, you get the tops cut, where all that second loader has to do is just whenever he picks it up, and you'll probably see him do it here in a minute, he just picks it up and he goes straight through the box with it, and it works beautifully that way.
Shut up, David.
Hey, so, you know, I was gonna title my video Completed Everything today because of something new that's out here that I ain't showed them yet, but instead I think I'm gonna tell them this is how you don't sharpen a saw that won't even cut through a butt.
Hey.
I literally got it all on.
Mickey done that, yeah. Mickey's free of Milo, remember? He's free of Milo. I bet he hit that darn trailer. I asked y'all this morning to sharpen the saw.
You ain't asked me.
Well, I asked Mickey one of them.
Mickey's the one cut my trailer.
Mickey been running around busier than hell.
I know. Listen, here's a cut better than that one.
I know it. Mickey was using that one while
been
ago.
Been being duller than hell for 2 days now, and you still ain't asked
Mickey
me.
Mickey done it.
Can you please, when you get time, sharpen that saw?
Nope.
Kenny, Mickey done it anyway.
Mickey done it,
Mickey
yeah.
done it.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Mickey done it. Mickey done it. Kelly's the only one trimming trucks around here.
No, Mickey trimmed me a while ago.
Kelly fixing to get wet.
Mickey done it.